we have a roll call, please?
Yes, Commissioner Hackler.
Here.
Commissioner Leeson.
Here.
Commissioner Lewis, absent. Commissioner Long, absent. Commissioner McLaren.
Here.
Commissioner McVeigh, absent. Commissioner Stewart, absent. Chairman Tetrick.
Here.
Commissioner Watson.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Thank you. Let's move on to item number two on the agenda. We've all had a chance to review the minutes from the last meeting. Is there any questions, concerns, corrections?
I move to approve as submitted.
I'll second it.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion passes. Thank you. All right, we'll move on to item number three, new business. Mr. Rickard, would you like to introduce that?
Yes, commissioners. Tim and Natalie Donjus are requesting a special use permit to allow a campground at 2953 Southeast Highway 54. Their property is currently zoned manufacturer home park residential district. Within that district, it does require a special use permit to allow a campground. The request will allow Deer Grove RV Park on the west side here in the red area with a red hatch line around it is the existing RV park. The property to the east, you see with the yellow boundary, is the property in question tonight, requesting the special use permit. You've all seen staff memo. We've gone through the zoning ordinance standards for review, and I'm open for any questions, or you can open the public hearing.
Yeah, at this time, we'll open the public hearing. Whoever would like to speak, please step up to the podium. State your name and your address, please.
My name's Tim Donjus, owner of Deer Grove RV Park, along with my wife. If you have any questions on the layout, I'm assuming that the city has given you everything that I've given them. If you have any questions on that information, I'd be more than happy to answer it. The electrical system has been designed by a company that actually does RV parks, specializes in that. And the size and the spaces and everything, we look at Good Sam. If you ever heard of Good Sam itself, they're an inspection company that represents RV parks across the nation. Similar, like you have hotels and motels that get inspected, but we also have requirements we have to have, such as lot size has to be a certain size, picnic tables, certain amenities that have to be there, and of course cleanliness, road conditions, and all those things apply. We also look at the National Fire Protection Association, what their requirements are, and we look at any requirements that we might have here from the city or the county on some of their stuff. There's a little bit differences between some of them, so we always take things kind of the higher scale on up. And existing traffic will continue to come through the current RV park. It'll access there, kind of on that northeast corner. It'll come through, and then it'll be a loop. A loop is a common design for RV parks.
You guys have any other questions for him?
For clarification, you know, we're looking at land use. A lot of these code issues are going to fall under Butler County. That's not within our jurisdiction. We're just looking at the zoning jurisdiction.
Right now, it's just vacant land with some trees on it.
Yes, actually, there was old lateral lines in there. We had, when we'd done some work on the existing RV park on the east side, we cut through some of those old lateral lines that were there. I think that was existing from when that mobile home park was built, probably of Hanks's, and then some from our RV park from years ago before the sewer was connected.
And so do you currently own the piece of property in question?
Yes, I own it up to the highway.
Okay. So is that your house?
Yes, that's a rental property.
We have. Okay.
We also own the rental property east of the main drive coming in.
That home, so the northern portion, it will be split off from the rest of the property. They've provided us a survey to make that happen.
Okay. Well, if I guess we don't have any more questions, you can be seated. Thank you. Anybody else like to speak to this?
David Hastings. I live directly in the middle of all of his properties there at 2901 South or Southeast US 54. Right now, I bought the house before Tim had purchased the property. I know what I was getting myself into then. I knew if I wanted to resell, what that would, you know, what that's doing to me. They purchased the property, came in, put in new campgrounds around the fence line. Ever since, I've been really having trouble with water issues. What's this next property going to do to that, you know? We have electric issues out there already. What is this going to do, you know, for that? What's my resale going to be? You know, I know I'm the only one here that actually has a problem with this. And trust me, I don't have a problem with business growing, by no means. But, you know, I've got another property that I want to build a house on. So, you know, am I going to get my money out of this house when that time comes? When, you know, it just, there's a lot of things there. So, anyway, that's my concerns.
Thank you.
Sir. When you say you have water issues and electrical issues, is that supply or?
No, water like
runoff?
Runoff. It just flows through my property like crazy.
Everything's probably going to that ditch along the highway, I imagine, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the other problem. The ditch, the drive there that we share comes down from the highway. And so all the properties drain right through my property. And, there's a small ditch on the east in between my house and his property there, but the water goes right through my house. I mean, it goes under the house. It's been a pretty big thing, but that's it. That's all I have.
Is the on the drainage issue? Do you know, is the drainage coming from this newly purchased?
Not the
land in question, or is it coming from the north?
It's coming from the west and the south.
Okay.
Scott.
Is that it?
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you know if the county would require any kind of stormwater?
You know, I'm not 100% sure if they do. I know they aren't like a city or a municipality where we are required to do that, and we have a discharge permit. I think if something like that was a concern of the majority of the board, you could add that onto your motion with maybe a site plan review from the county planning department for drainage, just to point that out, that there was a concern.
Because it's more likely just going to get worse if all that's
with more gravel, yeah.
Sir? I'm sorry, I don't remember what your name is.
Tim.
Have you done any studies about the drainage or?
No, you go out there and you stand, you watch when it rains and you see how it runs. I mean, that's what we do. And we try to fix issues where we got them. I know when I look at David's property, I look at the house we own east of David's property, and the house actually west, actually, but all those houses right there were never actually, in my opinion, built properly from the get-go on foundation. They're actually, you know, we're looking at, when we look south of the park, up towards where Hanks's is, That's all coming from the hill. I mean, water runs downhill, and so all that water is just coming down the hill. And of course, the road then acts as a dam, and we're reliant on the drainage that goes underneath the highway. Currently, you know, with this new part of the park that we're looking at building, I really don't see where we're gonna really put any more drainage or anything different on Mr. Hastings' property. I think majority of it's gonna run on our ditch area he talked about that's located, would be located on the northwest corner that would be straight down that line. There's a low area from my rental house up at the highway to his house at the highway, and they drain into this low area where the majority of the water runs down a fence line for the most part. I don't see where we're gonna add to anything that's anything more than what would affect his house and what he's currently dealing with. I don't think we're gonna add to that that's already there. If I'm gonna add to anything, it's gonna be to my own personal stuff. But again, you know, we're talking about water running down a hill. I mean, when it rains hard, it comes off of Blue Stem Roads, runs through Hanks Parks, runs to Caffer Road, goes across Caffer Road, goes into Mr. Ramsey's, because he's the lowest spot. So water runs downhill. So those are things that we have to deal with. It has to do with the lay of the land and what we have. Okay?
Thank you. Would anybody else like to add anything to that? Okay. At this time, we'll close the public hearing. Any discussion amongst the commission?
Be good if we took Scott's recommendation.
I agree.
Ask the county to check into it.
I agree.
Otherwise,
I think anytime you have new development occur around old development and probably a highway being reconstructed since homes were built there, everyone tries to grab the high ground. And I think it's important that you look at adjacent properties and how they're affected.
Okay. Do we have a motion?
I move to recommend approval of case number 18-07-SUP, a request by Natalie and Tim Donges for a special use permit to allow a campground on the property located 2953 Southeast Highway 54, with the add-on that the county look into the drainage of it.
Okay.
For the reasons set forth in the staff recommendation and heard at this public meeting.
Thank you. We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Mr. Rickard, can we have a roll call vote, please?
Yes. Commissioner Watson.
Here. Or, yes.
Chairman Tetrick.
Yes.
Commissioner McLaren.
Yes.
Commissioner Leeson.
Yes.
Commissioner Hackler.
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.
Thank you. Okay, we'll move on to item number 4, old business. Mr. Rickard, do we have any old business?
We have new business, no old business.
Perfect. Okay, with no old business, we'll move on to item number 5. Any staff items?
Yes. Would like to schedule, although we have no items agenda for November 15th, would like to just schedule a meeting and have just kind of a roundtable discussion about some of the things that have occurred over the last year. I think we want to talk about accessory structures and is what we have in our zoning regulations appropriate. Talk about things like scale and size and scope of buildings within neighborhoods. Things we're getting feedback from the public, things we're getting feedback from the city commissioner. I think things you've all tried to tackle in the last year and have had questions and trying to understand that. So if you all would entertain that, we'd love just to have a sit down. We would provide dinner and just kind of do an informal discussion, but actually hold a public meeting, but it'd be more down in this area. And then
At the previous meeting, y'all, the South Emporia Cestry structure, the city commission followed your recommendation to deny that, and North Vine Street rezoning went through. Right now on the North Vine Street, we just got some conceptual plans in today for the development there, so we're seeing things progress.
Good, good. Thank you. Well, with no other items, do we have a motion for adjournment?
Scott, I might ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
I didn't go down and look at it, but I heard rumors. You remember we denied the South Emporia building of those homes, you know, in there?
Yes.
Okay. Is there one at the north end built that's a slab? Is there a slab at the
Yeah, I think that was the type of construction they used.
I think that's a single-family home.
Yeah, it's not a duplex or a multi-family dwelling.
Yeah, it's a single-family home.
And those subject lots that you guys discussed, I can't recall the date, but all that property's going up for auction.
Yeah, I didn't see that. I know that's coming up.
Osberger stuff?
Yeah. Anything else? Do we have a motion to adjourn?
I move we adjourn.
I second it.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Meeting is adjourned.